Hey, it's Fran. Again in the lab. Deja vu, right? Yeah, I haven't closed this up yet, but this is the tech light display that I showed in a previous video a couple weeks ago, and many of the comments, firstly, people were saying, Fran, you didn't even fire it up. Why didn't you fire it up? Well, there's nothing to fire up. I mean, this is a completely discreet display. You got 16 lamps and 18 switches, and they all go down through the back plane, so there's nothing to fire up. There's no electronics in this. In order to get all the light bulbs to light up, I'd have to individually wire them up through the socket to a power supply, and the switches, they just switch. Very little to see here, but one of the other comments people were making about this is the fact that it has incandescent lamps, and they were saying, Fran, that seems so stupid. I mean, incandescent lamps, light bulbs burn out, and you know, a really expensive piece of kit like this, and you can't replace the individual lamps, it just seems like they would blow out, and you'd have to throw away the whole thing, and how could that work as a product? Well, this comes from a different world. In the 1960s, when this was made, I think it was like 1965, this was manufactured. This is, of course, a Burroughs-branded part, and this would have been incorporated into Burroughs machines, Burroughs computer systems. And back in those days, in the 1960s, you didn't own a computer. You couldn't buy a computer. If you had a mainframe system in your business or in your office, whatever, you leased it. You leased it from Burroughs or a company that distributed and maintained systems for Burroughs, like a subcontractor, but basically you leased the system. So if a lamp were to burn out on a module like this, you would contact the company that you leased it from, and they'd send a tech over with a new module, and they'd plug a new module in, and they would take the old one and leave, and that's how this stuff worked. But in truth, these lamps most certainly would not have burned out because the circuitry and the values on these resistors shows that they are using the tried and true trick for very long-lasting incandescent bulbs and filaments and tubes, which is always on. So the lamps in this display, when the module is plugged in, the lamps are always powered. Not incandescing, but always on. And if the filament is always on, and always pulling current, and always staying warm, then the fluctuations in the temperature and the current from turning the bulb on and off, even very rapidly, would not cause the filament to fail and shatter. Yeah, so let's investigate this idea of always-on filaments. So, I set up this little 6-volt bulb and a little socket, and I got a 6-volt lantern battery, and if I make the simplest circuit and simply connect it up. Yeah, you got the bulb coming on, right? Simple circuit. So with incandescence, unlike LEDs, you don't have a dropping resistor to make this work because the filament itself is a resistor. The filament itself, the way it's constructed, its specific resistance and how long the filament is and such, it self-limits itself. So as soon as you apply a voltage that it's rated for, it will automatically draw the maximum amount of current that it can, and it'll just stay there. It's a self-regulating kind of component. But, as everyone knows, light bulbs burn out, particularly if you run them at their rated voltage, completely unrestrained, and let them draw the maximum amount of current, and particularly if you run them that way, and turn them on and off a lot, well, eventually metal fatigue sets in and the filament will start to get these micro cracks, and it only comes to the very last time that you throw the switch, apply the current, and pop, the filament is broken. But there's a way to make a filament last a really long time, almost indefinitely, and that is to run it at a fraction of its rated power and run it all the time. This was a very common thing back in the days when incandescent bulbs were used in large signage. Just like in all this footage that was shot by 12 volt vids, which thanks for 12 volt vids for letting me use this. But yeah, he shot this stuff in 1987 showing the original strip in Las Vegas with all these amazing, huge incandescent displays fluttering about and blinking and animating and all this stuff. These light bulbs are turning on and off very quickly and very rapidly, lots of them. And if you have signs like this, then, you know, you don't want to have to be replacing bulbs every day, and you certainly don't want a sign that has lots of blown out bulbs in it. You want the bulbs to run a really long time, and surprisingly they will if you always keep the filaments on. But how does that work? So, I'm going to use my lantern battery and built a little circuit down here. So I've got two sets of resistors. I've got a 10 ohm 2 watt resistor here, and then I have a couple quarter watt resistors just because that's what I have in stock, and I've doubled them up 100 ohm and 470 ohm. It's about 82 ohms on this side. So I've got an 82 ohm resistance here, 10 ohm resistance there, and when I hook up the lamp and hook up the battery, I've got a multimeter here for rating the current. I want to take a look at the current that we're drawing here. Right. So notice that we've got 70 milliamps, and the bulb is not on. Got some glare here, but yeah, there's the filament is not incandescing. There's nothing there to see, but it is drawing 70 milliamps, which is not an insignificant amount of current. But if I close this little switch here and switch it over to the 10 ohm resistor, yeah, that's pulling about 200 mils. And it's glowing pretty brightly. In fact, with the 10 ohm resistor, it's glowing, it's like 3/4 full power as far as brightness goes. And when it's in the off state, it's still pulling about 70 milliamps. And so if I switch this really fast, okay, this is like the Las Vegas signage blinking really fast like this. Right? And when it's off, it really is off as far as a light bulb goes. It's not incandescing, but it is still on. And in this state, this always on state, I could continue to blink this light for months and it would not blow out. Now, if it were going completely on and completely off at full current, if there was no restriction, right, if I weren't restricting the amount of current it could draw, if I was letting it go wide open, and if when it was off, it was completely off and allowing the filament to completely cool down and not pull any current, well, then you could blink the light like this and it would not last for months. It would probably blow out within weeks. Obviously, the thing to do with this would be to set up a bench test with a couple different light bulbs and have them all blinking and have some of them current limited and some of them not. And you think, Fran, why don't you set that up and do that? Well, I could do that, but it would take months for light bulbs to begin to fail, and FranLab is just not set up for that kind of long experiment arc. I'm going to leave this on. I'm going to grab my thermal camera. Okay, those are the resistors. Kind of hot. And then the light bulb. Yeah. I think that the filament is just simply too small, because this does have like a minimum size that it'll scan. I think it's just probably too small a dot. But if I drop this resistance a little bit, let's say I drop this down to 50 ohms. Now the filament is on, so you can see that there. It's glowing ever so faintly. See it in there? So now it's actually incandescing a little bit. And it is drawing about 100 milliamps. But it doesn't have to be that hot, you know. So ideally, for it to have the maximum like thermal performance, for it to be on but not actually incandescing, for this bulb, it's probably going to be somewhere around 65, 70 ohms would probably be ideal, somewhere in the middle between the two. See, it's pulling almost 100 milliamps, so it's basically almost on. But, so now it's really always on. Yeah. And at this state here, let's see here, it's actually on. Yeah, you can see it right there. So yeah, it's showing up. So, but the idea is that the filament is always warmed up. It's always at a temperature, and so the thermal variation for turning on and off, it isn't going to be anything near what it would be if the bulb were actually turning on and off completely. But yeah, always on. Okay, well, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks too to everybody down on the Patreon making all these videos possible. Thank you, everybody on Patreon. So yeah, I'm Fran. I'll be back here doing something, you know, maybe a little more serious sometime real soon. All right.
Berserk in my lab, it's where I work. What you're watching. Friend love. It's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again.